Hello, my name is Elise Boris, and today I will be discussing how the mistreatment of women due to patriarchal views affects them in their domestic and social lives. I conducted my research by examining the question, how has this historically implemented patriarchy affected women and their role in society? By guiding my research using this question, I came to the conclusion that patriarchy has negatively impacted women's views on themselves and their ability to prosper in a male-dominated society. To support my research, I will start off by explaining an opposing viewpoint. Some may argue that religion does not have patriarchal values and does not oppress women. For example, in an interview with Leila Abu Lagoon, a Muslim woman who has worked with women's issues in the Middle East for over 20 years, she discusses that when Americans look at conflicts in the Middle East, they look for a cultural icon to cover up the messy politics and history involved. Abu Lagoon explains that Americans have chosen a helpless Muslim woman to be this icon, using this as propaganda to support intervention in the East. She states, the problem gets framed as one about another culture or religion, and the blame for the problems in the world is placed on Muslim men, now neatly branded as patriarchal. Abu Lagoon explains that Muslim women are now not as inhibited from religion as American propaganda portrays them to be. This asserts that Muslim women are not affected by the instilled patriarchy in Islam. To counter Abu Lagoon's views, we must examine how women's roles in communities are largely determined by the views of their cultures and the norms of their society. One can see that the explicit difference in Abu Lagoon's ideals of Islamic culture when comparing it to an article from the Journal of Affective Disorders titled Women's Mental Health in Muslim World, Cultural, Religious, and Social Issues. This article explains that due to the traditionally subordinate position of women in Islam, they are shown to be a higher risk factor for mental health disorders in the culture. The article states, women are definitely at a greater risk of developing mental disorders such as depressive, somatoform, anxious, or eating disorders, as well as suicidal behaviors. This statistic connects the patriarchal culture of Islam to the increase of mental health issues in the religion. This negative association of women in religion is also seen in Christianity. In her academic journal article titled Women, Sex, and Patriarchy, author Lies Fortier, former president of Planned Parenthood Federation of Canada, discusses how religion adds to the conversation of a woman's role in society. Fortier touches on Christianity and the story of Adam and Eve and how it attaches a negative connotation to females and sex. She writes, the belief that sex is evil, dangerous, and introduced by women is also part of the Judeo-Christian myth of Eve and Adam. Eve, a disguised goddess of fertility, for she was the mother of all things, was seduced by a snake, and the whole story of Eve and Adam is about sex and its consequences, namely death and the loss of happiness and simplicity. To understand the detriments of a patriarchal society, one must also examine how gender roles affect women's mental health states. Because women are often expected to take on all the domestic roles in a household, rather than distributing them equally with a male, domesticated women often see deterioration in mental health. In Tom Calasanti's academic journal article, Gender Inequality and the Division of Household Labor in the United States and Sweden, a Socialist Feminist Approach, Calasanti discusses how the unequal distribution of household chores affects women. He states, gender inequality in the division of household labor entails important economic and social physiological consequences for women. Constraints imposed by childcare and housework influence the jobs women obtain, the hours they work, and the pay they receive. Further, employed women, and not men, experience an overburden of domestic labor to the detriment of their psychological well-being. These extra tasks, along with workplace pressures and stress, result in increased mental health issues in women. Women can also be negatively affected by harassment and degradation in education in the workplace. At a young age, women feel the pressure of needing to work extremely hard to even compare to a male. In most countries, extra roadblocks are put in their way as well. In George Prince Atta's academic journal article, Education Inequality, How Patriarchy and Policy Collide in Ghana, Atta discusses the hardship girls have to go through just to get to school and the harassment that occurs when they finally arrive. Atta begins by explaining that girls in Ghana usually do not receive an education due to the lack of money or belief that women are incapable of making their own decisions, so they don't deserve an education. For women who are lucky enough to escape these prerequisite barriers, there still lie more to come when they get to school. Out of states, classmates take advantage to prey on their female counterparts by abusing them sexually and physically. Male teachers also take advantage of their female students to prey on them. Oftentimes, male teachers threaten to fail them in examinations, humiliate them in public, harass, abuse, and tease them. However, if women receive proper education and make it to the workplace, these issues do not get any better. Men continue to sexually harass women as they move into the workplace and further into their careers. In a study done by CNBC, it was found that 27% of women have been sexually harassed in the workplace. However alarming the statistic may be, what is more alarming is how males view sexual harassment. In a survey study done by Amitav Banerjee, editor-in-chief of the Journal of Medicine, Banerjee found a stark contrast between men and women's views on workplace sexual harassment. Banerjee found that while 70% of men believe that women are at fault for their own harassment, only 49% of women believe this. This 21% difference shows how males take advantage of females in the workplace and see no wrong doing so. As explained by the research conducted, women counter patriarchal views and policies that limit them in work, education, and life. To eliminate these patriarchal ideals, our society must rid itself of gender roles in the home. This would lessen the domestic pressures of women and distribute the home chores more equally. This would also help diminish gender discrimination in the workplace and education. The gap must also be closed to ensure full rights for the wage gap must also be closed to ensure full rights for women. On Equal Pay Day 2018, Hillary Clinton, nominee for the Democratic Party in 2016 presidential election, discusses the wage gap and urges the passage of the Paycheck Fairness Act. This legislature would allow workers to discuss their pay without being fired or retaliated against for learning about their coworkers' salaries and confronting employers. This enables women to confront employers about wage gaps and hopefully bring about change. An implication to this solution is fathers would have to take a larger role in home life and helping with children. In turn, they would need a larger amount of maternity leave like mothers currently receive. A limitation to this solution is that patriarchal views are embedded into religion. Since people centralize their morals around and ideals around religion, the church, a long-standing conservative institution, would need to change its ideals as well.
Elise, thank you. I'd first like to ask, how valid and reliable are the sources you've used? How do you know?
I believe they're very credible. I look to a lot of databases, which are peer-reviewed articles, when I was doing my research. And I also implemented credibility statements in my work to show the validity of them.
Okay. All right. Thank you. And then what advice would you have for others researching your topic?
I would advise others to really look at every perspective. There's a lot of different perspectives on this topic, both conservative and most, and like against women, for women, misogynistic viewpoints. So just look at all of them, and even if you're against one of the viewpoints, then you can use it to counter something and make your claim stronger.
Okay. All right. Well, thank you.